Alright guys, this is Daragon from YouTube, and as you know in the video, first off, you're gonna obviously need one of these. Basically what it does, it puts HDMI to mini or micro USB. I think it's mini because this is smaller than it might be micro, because it's smaller than mini. Mini is the ones that fit into like hard drives and stuff, but you're gonna need something similar like this, first off, to set it up, and obviously a phone that supports this option. So let's get to it, and I'll show you a walkthrough of how this actually works and how you set it up. Alright guys, basically for this you're gonna need obviously a phone that goes to micro USB, as seen right here. Sorry for this messy thing. You're gonna need this adapter, because one, you know, it is mini. Let it focus, it won't say mini eventually, I hope. It was doing fine before, but then I messed up my video. And it has this and this. Why do you need the wire? Well, because basically this hosts the thing on your screen and this powers it. It uses too much power, so you need two power sources. Well, you need a power source, plus you need this to have it work. But anyway, let's get to the video. Okay guys, for this demonstration, I'm gonna use my Wii U because this is the easiest way to set it up right now, because I don't have an extra HDMI. So I'm gonna unplug the HDMI as I did here, and then I'm going to plug it in. Just hold up a sec. Alright guys, this is the basic setup. Basically, you have this plug in right here, right? You have it going into the HDMI, and then you have your charger plug plugged into something that supports USB. Right now, I'm using my Wii U because, one, the HDMI is around, and two, you know, it has a USB source. Some TVs have a USB source, but be warned, you do need a USB thing to power it as you record it while having it in here. So basically, it's a three-point setup. I'll take a picture and then I'll show you it. Okay guys, as you see right here, you have the screen. Let me unfocus it for a second. It's on the TV, as you can see. Works really well. I think it's pretty good, at least in my opinion. Basically, now, as you see right here, move this around, maneuver it. I'm using my phone and it's correlating, as you see. I don't know if you can. Yeah, you can see a little movement, but yeah. So you see, it displays a picture. It works in every mode. The thing I like about it is that it does rotate with you. So let's download a game. Let's get Vector, I guess, real quick. I should have prepared this, but I didn't. I just got the wire, so I guess I kind of got excited. If I recall correctly, it flips like that on your screen once you load up a game, and it will play it sideways, which I find pretty cool. I think it's really good for reviews, and it plays the sound out of your TV, as you see. It's pretty loud. There's almost no lag from what I've noticed. It's just my phone that lags it, so, you know. Of course, there's an ad, you know, NFL, thanks for, I probably have an ad in an ad as I add. That's funny. But, yeah, as you see, it works. Works well. It's almost like no lag on it. I think it's pretty cool. I was even trying. I doubt I got 3 stars, but whatever. Yeah, I didn't get 3 stars, so I'm gonna cry about it. But yeah. As you see, you know, there's stuff like this. I don't want my stuff being seen, like my friends and stuff, so. Yeah, I have a kick and all that, you know. As you see, everything works pretty fine from what I noticed. I haven't had anything incompatible with it. It's just a matter of if your phone can handle it, and all that jazz, you know. I find it useful because then I don't have to, you know, look at my phone screen and have my fingers blocking it. I just feel where it is, though then again, sometimes it depends on the game. I just figured this would be very useful for phone reviews, so if there's like an app I actually care about, which is quite rare, I could just do it like this. And yeah, it was like $6, I'll leave a link. Took a while to get it because I ordered it from like Japan, and stuff. So yeah, this phone ain't the best. Is the HTC Evo has problems sometimes loading stuff, but I mean, it does work, as you see, you know, like, look at that. See, I don't know if it's the actual phone. Hold up, let me close this. This. And this, alright. So, yeah, as you see, it displays everything pretty properly. I don't know why this game ain't running that good. I don't know why I didn't die. I thought I was gonna die. Yeah, dude in his perfect jump. Yeah, I mean, it displays everything pretty smooth. I guess it does use some of the power of the phone. You know, it's not gonna run the best, but, you know, certainly not the worst. I think it runs pretty good for what it is. I don't know if there's, like, that many other games that I have, you know? It's like, you could also check YouTube and shit, and I don't know why I would want to use an internet browser and all that jazz. Yeah, if you guys want suggestions of, I guess Minecraft Pocket Edition. No! This dude's insisting on adding me for some reason. We'll download this, test it. And see how Minecraft Pocket Edition installs. You know, it runs fairly smooth. I like it. It's not the worst. It's not the worst. I'll give it that. This dude's like, you know, it's retarded. But I didn't want to do creative mode. But as you see, you know, it runs pretty smooth from what I'm seeing. It's not the best, but yeah. You know, I only wanted this for reviews, like I said. I guess there is lag while playing games, but I haven't really noticed it other than the Vector game. This game has pretty bad controls, but you know, if you wanted to play Minecraft Pocket Edition on your phone, you know, you just.
Alright guys, my bad, you know. My camera died, so therefore I had to stop the video. As you see, the TV is in the background and everything. Basically, that's all you really need to do it. It works well. It was worth $6. I'll leave a link in the description of, you know, how much it cost or whatever. And, yeah, I mean, I think it's good. It will orient it vertical when it needs to, when it's in the correct aspect, but when it's horizontal, the screen will detect it and switch it to the side, which I find very useful, so you can play your games if you want. I'm probably going to be using this for future reviews. I think it's a fairly good device, if I say so myself. It's definitely worth it, and yeah, if you have any questions about it, let me know. Just the basic concept is, you need a USB power source. You can use your laptop, you can use a TV if you have USB input in your TV. You can use a Wii U or a console that you have, or you can use the outlet, matter of fact. You just need it close by so you could actually host the screen, and that's about it. I find it pretty cool. You're not going to really want to use it much. I guess it's just cool to have for some people. I think it's useful. So yeah, it's me, Daragon. Deuces. Hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a like, comment, subscribe. Check out the rest of my videos, and that's it. Deuces.